Hello, my name is Isaac Lotta and I'm an Applications Engineer supporting Position Sensing Products. In this video, we will dive into more detail on ring magnets found in the Texas Instruments Magnetic Sense Simulator. The TIM simulation environment is capable of simulating three types of ring magnets: axial ring magnets, radial ring magnets, and diametric ring magnets. Axial ring magnets are selectable in TIMs under axial rings. Axial rings with two poles are magnetized so that the magnetic poles are at the top and the bottom of the flat circular faces of the magnet. When creating a multipole axial ring magnet, the amount of poles is incremented by multiples of 4. On a multipole axial ring magnet, the number of poles will vary if you are looking at the magnet from the side view or the top view. Let's take a 4-pole axial ring magnet, for example. When viewed from the outer round portion of the magnet, we can see that there are 4 poles, but when observing from the top, where the flat circular faces are located, only half of the magnet's total number of poles will be viewable. For a 4-pole axial ring, we can see only 2 poles. TIMS allows users to create an axial magnet with a limit of up to 64 poles. Diametric ring magnets are selectable in TIMS under ring magnet option. When editing the ring magnet type under magnet specifications, if the pole count is entered as 2, the simulation environment will generate a diametric ring. A diametric ring is composed of 2 magnetic poles that are parallel along the diameter of the magnet, splitting the flat circular faces in half. The diametric ring will have the same number of poles in the top or the outer round portion of the magnet. When increasing the amount of poles in the ring magnet type in TIMS, the tool will generate a radial ring magnet. Radial rings are polarized so that the poles create an inner circle adjacent to the hole, as well as a set of poles that generate an outer circle. In TIMS, starting with a minimum of 4 poles, radial magnets can be incremented by multiples of 2. Just like the axial ring we discussed earlier, the radial magnet will also have a different number of poles if you are looking at the magnet from the side view or the top view. Taking a 4-pole radial ring, for example, when viewed from the outer round portion of the magnet, we can see that there are 4 poles, but when observing from the top, where the flat circular faces are located, the number of poles viewable is doubled. In this case, of the 4-pole radial ring, 8 poles would be viewable from the top. When purchasing a radial ring magnet from a magnet supplier, they may specify the amount of poles on the magnet by referring to the amount of poles that are available on the outer side view. It is also common for vendors to not portray the magnetic poles on the inner circle of the ring on their datasheet. TIMS will allow users to create a radial ring magnet with a limit of up to 64 poles. Axial ring magnets are magnetized through the thickness or height of the magnet, while diametric rings are magnetized across the diameter, and lastly, radial ring magnets are magnetized along the radial vectors of the magnet. This concludes our content on ring magnets. To learn more about TIMS and TI Magnetic Sense Portfolio, please review the relevant collateral listed here. To get started on your simulations using ring magnets, please visit www.ti.com/TIMS, and thanks for watching.